Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi, from every mountainside. We face the difficulties of today and tomorrow. I still have a dream.
Tonight was Negro Spiritual Night, sponsored by the King Solomon Historical Preservation Society. As a people who were not allowed to read books in the days of slavery, often African Americans, then blacks, or to use an even older term, Negroes, sang what they heard from the preacher, what they were preached to at church. They often put it in song. Also about their everyday trials and tribulations. They saw in the Jews of the scriptures, they saw a similar heritage, a role of shared suffering. And so that evolved into song. And as you know, Negro spirituals formed the foundation of all American music, jazz, rock and roll, gospel, blues, all have that common heritage that was found across the plantations throughout the South, and also extending over into the even the sharecropping period and Jim Crow. It's the story of people who were oppressed, who sang about overcoming, who hoped for deliverance. And so tonight, we asked some of the best choirs around, and we also chose them because of geography. Schools in Madison Parish, Louisiana, Vicksburg, Piney Woods Country Life School, and Alcorn State University. We wanted to show the progression from high school to college, not only in voice, but also in maturity, in what you sing, how you sing, and really about life stories. Tonight was about bringing all of them together to sing what is the basis, really, of all American music. What we're talking about are areas that are traditionally underserved, areas that traditionally produce children who are born out of wedlock, but you're really in training, life training. Because a lot of us who were born in these areas, my brother-in-law graduated from Piney Woods. My mother-in-law tells it that she and father-in-law had to send that boy somewhere where somebody can teach him something. And I want to tell you that you're absolutely right. Most of us share something in these areas. We have a commonality. And that is, sometimes we're running from trouble, sometimes we're going into trouble, sometimes we make trouble. Sometimes it's not trouble of our own. Perhaps dad was not there, perhaps mother was not there, perhaps we made some bad decisions. And so we find ourselves in an Alcorn State Gospel Choir, we find ourselves in Madison Parish, Louisiana, in that choir. And we think that choir director is being so hard on us and just doesn't understand. Well, when I was at Lanier High School way back when, we used to call Carl Twiner Daddy T, because he was like a father substitute to many of us. And his guidance went far beyond the notes on a piece of paper and teaching us the four parts to a song. It extended way beyond that. We followed him home. He took us different places that we never thought we'd go. And sure, some of us complained and some of us backbit him. But in the end, he was pastoring way back when. And it is the same, I'm sure, at Piney Woods, the same at Madison Parish. Our kids need more. They need more. We have to stand in the gap for what's lacking. Educators in our community don't get off when the bell rings. It's almost an around-the-clock job to make up for some of our shortcomings. And in short, what our choir directors, what our educators are doing is putting some want to in us.
Let it ring from every village to every hamlet, from every state to every city. We will be able to speed up the day where all of God's children, black men, white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, we'll be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we're free at last. Before I sit down, I'd like to say something. We all know that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. is a great man that has stood up for what we believe in, our race, and everything. But everybody should know, Dr. King did not die for us. Jesus is the one that died for us.
Everybody up here needs to get up on their feet when he said that. Everybody up here needs to be sitting up on their feet when he said that.
We all know that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was a great man that stood up for everything he believed in and made it possible for all the opportunities that we have going for us now in this great nation. But everybody should know, it's all thanks to Jesus. Jesus gave us the opportunities that we have now. So if anything, you should be giving the praise all to Jesus, because he died for us. He hung on Calvary's cross, but 3 days later rose back up and went to heaven with our Lord and Savior. That's all I have to say.
And we're just going to do it for you guys, a little gospel message, if that's okay. So if you will, can you please clap like this?